Global National with Donna Friesen. Reporting tonight, Colleen Christie.
Good evening. Thanks for joining us. Canadians are ringing in the new year with new federal carbon taxes in four provinces. Starting today, large emitters in Saskatchewan, Manitoba, Ontario, and New Brunswick will shell out for failing to come up with their own levies on emissions. Come April 1st, drivers will start paying more too. The Trudeau Liberals claim pricing carbon is the best and most efficient way for Canada to fight climate change. The opposition says it amounts to a tax that will hurt average Canadians and the economy. Our chief political correspondent David Aiken tells us the growing debate could become one of the defining issues in this year's federal election.
Good afternoon and happy new year.
Andrew Scheer kicked off 2019 aiming at what will be his favorite target this election year.
Welcome to the year of the carbon tax. Today, Justin Trudeau's signature tax hike begins to take effect.
Manufacturers and other big businesses start paying the federal carbon tax today in Ontario, Saskatchewan, Manitoba, and New Brunswick. And on April 1st, there will be a tax, a few pennies to start, on every liter of fuel purchased by consumers in those provinces.
Driving to work, heating your home, and even buying groceries in stores just like this. Everyday essentials will become more expensive this year thanks to the Trudeau carbon tax.
Though Scheer has not yet announced his own plan to fight climate change, the Tories are convinced that Canadians in those four provinces will be angry about higher energy costs, and that anger will translate into votes for their party this October. But the Trudeau Liberals have an answer to ease that anger, a cash rebate program that is a key part of the carbon tax legislation.
We will send a climate action incentive directly to Canadians to help them adjust to an economy in which pollution is no longer free.
The rebates could be between $400 to $600 per year per household, paid for the first time on this spring's tax returns. Liberals believe that cash back will take the sting out of future higher energy costs. Still, internal government polling data obtained by Global News shows that the issue is not necessarily a slam dunk for either Conservatives or Liberals. In a poll done the week of November 9th, the federal government's pollster asked Canadians if they supported or opposed the carbon tax and rebate system. Among those living in Saskatchewan and Manitoba, it was pretty much a draw, 46% supporting and 44% opposed. In Ontario, 43% support the federal plan, 32% do not. For the whole country, it was 47% in favor, 29% against.
Only about one in five of those polled by the government itself were undecided about Ottawa's carbon tax and rebate plan. And it's those 20% who are undecided that both Scheer and Trudeau will be fighting to win over to their view of the carbon tax, with the hope that they'll also win their votes this October. Colleen?
David, the politics of this carbon tax will no doubt be important in the months ahead, but will this tax do what it's designed to do, help Canada meet its international obligations to cut greenhouse gas emissions?
Well, carbon taxes in general can work, and we've seen that in British Columbia, for example. BC has had a carbon tax for a decade. Emissions there have dropped, and it's important to note, BC has led and is expected to continue to lead all provinces in economic growth. So, yes, these things work, but there are plenty of experts, from the parliamentary budget officer to nonpartisan panels of scientists, which say the Trudeau carbon tax will not have much effect because it's not steep enough. It's just 20 bucks a ton right now, and it's unlikely to have much immediate effect on prices at that level, despite what the Tories say, and therefore it's unlikely to force a lot of change in the short term. In fact, some have said that for Canada to rapidly cut its GGEs in order to meet that Paris Accord targets, it would need a carbon tax of at least $100 a ton, and perhaps something closer to $400 a ton. Colleen?
David Aiken in Ottawa. Thanks, David.